Thank you, dear colleague, professor at the University of Liège, for this invitation. Ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues and friends, European, American, and from other parts of the world, that's also, and perhaps first of all, as professor of the University of Liège, that I am happy to be here. And it's also because of that that I will have to leave you immediately after my introduction, because, and I have a very good excuse, I'm teaching at 4 o'clock in Liège. I have to take the train because with the car to go out of Brussels, you have to hold more than a patent. And so I'm happy to introduce, notwithstanding, to introduce this first conference organized by the brand new Liège. You can have the French pronunciation, but for the rest, that's in English, Competition and Innovation Institute, LCII. Founded by three professors of the University of Liège, Professors Artige, Gauthier, and Petit. And as Nicolas said, to explore the complex relationship between competition and innovation, and to promote research and discussion on competition and innovation policies in Europe. This institute is the heir of a very long-standing tradition at the University of Liège, tradition in European law in general. Five of our professors in European law have been appointed since the 70s as judges at the European Court of Justice. But not only in European law in general, but in competition law in particular, beginning with René Joliet. René Joliet, I'm proud to have been his assistant at the University of Liège 45 years ago, whose pioneering works build bridges between Europe and the United States competition research. Tradition continuing with well-known scholars in the field as Mr. Papalardo, De Marais, Jean-François Bélis, Damien Gérardin, and the new young professors that you are going to meet today. Everything accompanying a successful LLM program in competition and intellectual property. As you said, this institute is based on the idea that cutting-edge research must be disseminated. Research and the results of the research must be known, but also it helps to confront theory and evidence, ideas and practice, and hopefully to bring a true improvement for society. This research must also be interdisciplinary, and that's the reason why this institute pulls academics from the economy, management, and law faculties, and that this conference brings together, as today, judges, civil servants, members of the bar, academics, practitioners with very different backgrounds. The conference of today, the hope is to make a contribution to the understanding of patent holdup. This assertion that patent owners can, under some circumstances, force extortionate terms on prospective licenses and halt, stop engines of innovation, goes back originally to the works of the competition economist who was Mr. Shapiro. However, its concrete implications are still far from being clear, give rise to many debates, controversies. That's what you are looking for, debates, controversies, intensified, namely, with the recent commission decision in the case Samsung-Motorola, and also by the case decided by the court, who I in which I was Advocate General, judgment which provides a framework of rules of good conduct on how to deal with injunctions in the field of the SCP. This conference, normally, should give the opportunity to go further on more questions, on some questions. Among others, how important is the patent holder problem? Are the policymakers going to give additional meaning to friend commitments? If yes, who should play a role in this process? Civil courts, arbitration tribunals, competition authorities, standard-setting organizations? Are there risks of adverse effects on innovation? And is it really possible that antitrust policy could promote innovation and safeguard competition? That's therefore with great pleasure that I'm declaring this conference open, that I declare the LCII definitively launched. So now you have to go further. The start is easy, to go further is difficult. And it's also a second pleasure, it's to give the floor to a friend, to a colleague, a brand new judge at the General Court of the European Union, who came from Scotland through Brussels and working now in Luxembourg, who, as member of the bar, has been at the center of many important competition cases brought to the General Court or the European Court of Justice, and namely the case Microsoft, in which we have common feelings at the time when I was a member of the bar and I had the pleasure to work with Jan Forrester. He said from the case Microsoft, and I quote, "It's like a jellyfish, shapeless and very painful." Not only the case, the decision also. And it makes me think to another quotation of Mark Twain, who said, "A country without good patent laws is just a crab and cannot travel anyway but sideways or backwards." My hope is that this conference and the Institute, activities in general, will not be a crab, neither a crab nor a jellyfish, but a bright salmon swimming upstream towards the sources and giving rise to useful and new discussions. I wish you a very good afternoon, and I have to be impolite. I am teaching European law in Liège. Thank you. Good afternoon.